We fuck you. Oh, you, how many corruption points does Hartwood have at this point?
Nowhere near as much as Lout.
Okay.
Well, yeah, that's right. You only got like.
You have two.
I yeah. hope so.
I got two. Yeah.
We don't know with Monty. I always think he has more because he does some risque shit.
He really doesn't, though. He just gets fucked. He does one dumb thing, and that snowballs out of control.
Ah, but he still did a dumb thing.
Yeah.
Like, exactly. It's still risque shit. It's something that a normal human being would stop and pause and think about it. About the repercussions. Monty just does it.
That's fair, actually.
He's only really gotten fucked once, though.
In this game.
Oh, yeah, in this game.
In this game only. And he's been avoiding his fucking knees because he doesn't come.
That's a great point Travis makes, actually. How many times will you have fucked up if you showed up these past three sessions?
Oh. Hard.
Yeah, good point. I don't know.
Josh, how do you feel being responsible for that guy?
Who?
Like, in-game. How Hartwin's responsible for Lot, basically, and everything Lot does reflects back on Hartwin.
You'll find out.
I'm not happy about it.
You'll find out.
is everyone here?
Yeah.
Present.
Yep.
I inject morphine back into Lout so he goes back to sleep.
Oh, man. Alright.
I proceed to throw him in the coral cage so he can collect clams on his barnacles.
Good.
So yeah, it's at the end. We ended it. It's now the fifth month of the year. I guess you've been traveling
God
for...
God damn!
What are you saying, goddamn, too? That's a fucking blink of an eye for your life, this man.
Oh, yeah, no shit, but just like, you fucking hell.
So, boats last a long time, man, and I have not released my post.
Yeah, so when you guys left, it was like, I think ending of like the second month, and then basically 3 months of just sailing, coming in of like the ports, and like, you know, not really sure what's going on, just following the flagship. And then the last session we left off with them holding the elven artifact, and
Lord Kruger.
Yeah, Kruger.
Kruger.
Yeah, Kruger is pointing off to the storm off in the distance. The fleet starts to shift directions towards the storm. Harrier looks towards Hartwin and says, "What are your orders, Captain?"
With a scout ship. And I just kind of look begrudgingly forward towards the storm, like scared shitless, like, we go forward.
Alright, yeah, all the sailors look pretty worried, but he says, you heard the captain, prepare the ship, strap everything tight, down tight, and you see the sailors running around and getting the ship ready for the, you know, for what's about to happen.
Should I still be in the crow's nest?
Yeah, I was just gonna ask you, what are you guys doing?
You should stay up there for now. We still need eyes. If you
quick question! What's the difference in vision from the crow's nest versus on deck?
I guess you could just, like, see, like, from, like, a higher view, I guess. So it helps your vision, I guess.
You actually do see more up in a crow's perch because you have a wider view of things than just being on
the ground. You better fucking tie yourself in there, though.
You missed your head down.
That's a dangerous situation.
God damn, if the fucking winds don't throw me off, the lightning's gonna fucking get my ass from.
Oh yeah, don't worry about it, it's coming.
I mean, it's better than being on deck where you can easily be washed off by the 100,000 waves that are coming.
Mm-hmm. You're fuck in the it. Worst place possible, but you're also in the safest place possible, so enjoy this.
I gotta Google what the fuck people in the Crow's Nest do during storms now.
Hold on for fucking dear life.
You pretty much tie yourself down with any kind of sturdy rope you can find, and you keep yourself covered at all times.
Yeah.
Alright, so what is everyone else doing? Harrier's the one that's, like, sailing the ship, because no one else can really do that.
I'm grabbing rope, seeing as how there's a storm coming, and I'm tying myself to the post.
To this one right here?
Yeah, the main one, like the one I'm standing right next to. I'm tying myself to it. It, like, whenever I wasn't working, I literally attached myself to it.
Okay. Louch chilling, I guess, somewhere.
Get overboard! From.
Yeah, what is Rika and Hartwind doing?
I stand at the front of the ship watching.
I'm standing next to something that I can grab onto. Probably the mast.
I watch my ultimate release from this horrible torment approach me.
Fred. Lout's gonna be like, I don't know, with the majority of the people, because he's not getting out of this one.
Fred's just gonna ask, would you like to be tied down to? He's like asking that to Rika, who's apparently next to him now.
Yeah, I'll probably just tie myself down in the Crow's Nest. That's... Oh, Matt, do you know anything about this situation? And what historically you do in this case, aside from sit it out?
I mean, to be fair, you don't know shit.
I mean, I've never been on a ship, like, in the middle of an ocean on a storm, so...
Historically, I gave you the best info possible, Ian. That was all they could do to keep themselves from falling off that bitch.
Just thinking, winds on the open sea can get really fucking strong because what propel ships around.
Also, I'm thinking,
and when you're like however tall the mast is up, the wind is even stronger. Mm-hmm. And you're in a storm, you're not even going to be able to see
visibility
shit.
Visibility is shit in a storm, yeah.
Yes.
There's no benefit to having someone up there.
Out of character.
I mean, your eyesight is better than most.
Get the fuck down from there, you're gonna die.
Yeah. Aren't we?
I mean, somebody has to be up there. I don't think
you're
you understand.
You're literally saying all this shit in front of someone who went to sailing school.
Did you?
Yes.
Then what happened?
What is the answer, then?
Generally, you need someone up there, because when you get the 100-foot waves, you need someone who can keep eyes of where everything is.
Mm.
That is a good
so point. You're our best bet. Someone has to be up in the Crow's Perch, and you have a better sight than most. So while a regular human's crippled, you're still seeing better than a regular human on average.
Yeah. Staying up here then, god damn it. That's what you're supposed to do, apparently, with Captain Hardwin. So, I don't fucking know.
It's just standard sailing on a boat, dude. Yeah.
I die, swear to God. I swear to God, Josh.
What god do you have, elf?
Several. Do you want me to list them?
No.
No, because they're all Greek to me.
Just say
whatever. Don't worry. You're not gonna die.
I really hope so.
Just be sure to tie yourself to that Crow's Nest.
Oh, yeah. Tying down, securing self, that kind of shit.
Are you tying yourself down too, Danny?
Side note, keep a knife handy in case the ship starts to capsize.
Good.
Why don't you go to sailor school? Out of curiosity.
My grandfather owned a yacht. What do you think he wanted his grandchildren to do?
Fair enough.
Alright, so...
I still don't know how to swim.
No, just Hartman. But he's got to be the face of this expedition for the side crew, so he's got to stay in front.
Oh, no, no, I was talking about Travis.
Wait, you can't swim, Travis?
No.
Are you fucking what?
I have a deep fear of the sea. I don't think you understand. I was in an actual flood. I don't like water.
Alright, so,
carry on.
Yeah, so you guys start heading towards... Everyone gets situated. sorry, I just had a brain fart. So your ship starts, you get situated and the ship starts to get closer and closer to the storm. The winds and waves start to become more wind has started blowing at a moderate rate. Waves now crash on the side of the ship. You're kind of just like easing your way into the storm. Now you're like on the very outskirts of like this of the storm. Out of nowhere, the winds and the waves start to become more aggressive. The rain stings when it strikes the skin, also making it pretty hard to see. Harrier's shouting like different commands to the sailors, and they're like running around trying to like, you know, just keep everything in order. Let's see. No one would see this really except for Nylafi. You look off to the right and you see a you look to the right off in the distance. A wave towers over two frigate ships, engulfing the two ships to the watery depths.
I will immediately warn the helmsman of this.
You just hear, Harrier kind of, shout, like, just cursing and all this other stuff. It says, "Captain, there's no way we're gonna survive this." And, like, you just see, like, off in the distance, the waves are just getting, like, super fucking, like, crazy. Like, they're towering, like, over, like, any, like, some, like, these waves would, like, take down, like, the capital ship if they were, like, caught in the midst of it.
We don't have a choice. We need to cut through them. We need to stay with the capital ship.
In front of you, everyone sees this. As you say that, a wave starts to form. And it gets larger and larger within seconds. Harry yells out, "Brace yourself!" And the ship starts to ride a giant wave, sending the ship off balance. Let's see. I guess, whoever's not tied down to something, make me a, athletics check.
I don't think we're... Well, I don't think the seamen are. I know Dietrich's not.
Dietrich ain't fucking tied down? Oh,
fortune
shit, hard one.
Point.
Oh, boy. Wow. Hey. The one time that it's worked.
Alright, and then I'm pretty sure Lau would have tied himself down, too.
Locke should be below deck. That nigga's not safe from here.
I'm gonna put Lau and Dietrich below deck, I guess.
Yeah, that makes some sense. Those two
are not safe up here.
Yeah, don't worry. If the ship capsizes, they're dead anyway.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So this is gonna be for one of the seamen.
Goodbye. We're just gonna see a dude fly off, aren't we?
Well, there's the Wilhelm scream.
Alright, so, you see, the wave kind of throws the ship off balance, splashing, like, you know, little mini waves onto the ship. Hard to win, you're able to kind of, keep your balance. It's pretty, it's pretty difficult to do so, though. I guess Rika and Frederick, you see this sailor right here get pulled into the ocean as one of the waves kind of strikes over him. Why is this stupid? And like lands at your guys' feet. Why the fuck?
Oh, what are you doing?
Nah, just my fucking browser's like tweaking up. So this guy falls overboard and he's like, ah!
Oh shit.
This guy loses his balance and hits his head on the cannon and gets stunned.
Oh damn.
And this guy is fine.
Oh fuck.
One for Harrier as well.
The helmsman dies.
Oh, he fucking banged his head on the goddamn boat.
Would Harry have screwed himself to the wheel or some shit?
That's a hard thing to do. That thing is constantly moving. Yeah.
I'm saying like the... Not the fucking massive, but the thing it's attached to the boat with. That's not moving.
Sure.
It is?
He still has to be mobile, so he can't securely, all the way.
He can't sit still.
Yeah.
That's his problem.
So he still has to be able to move around and stuff. Yeah. So I mean he gets thrown around a little. But he's fine.
Yeah. Like the thing on a surfboard kind of, you got plenty of slack, it's just you're not flying off this damn boat. You'll slip and eat shit, mm-hmm. Sure, but beyond that.
So this guy falls off. So you guys ride the huge wave out, and you guys kind of start going on a decline of the wave, and there's just this other big ass wave right behind it, and you guys start to ride that one as well.
Lord Jesus!
Everyone, I guess, Hartwin, give me another athletics check.
Hey. Oh, Jesus! Oh, Sigma!
This guy gets washed off,
Oh, shit.
Stunned.
Oh, yeah, he's stunned. He can't roll! Oh, no.
Fortune, favor me.
Alright.
Oh, no.
Ah! Do you have, could use, a resolve or a resilience? Or not a resolve, but a resilience, if you wish.
Yeah, you'd have to burn, so...
Also,
yeah.
The corruption point.
Well, I'm getting washed off, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I guess I'll throw a resolve down.
Resilience. Has to be resilience.
Yeah, it's where you automatically pass. So when you spin your resilience, your resolve goes down because you can't have more resolve than resilience because it's fate and fortune.
Yeah, resolve wouldn't help in this situation with the things that encompass. It has to be resilience here.
Yeah, I don't really have an option. Oh. Otherwise, it's just death anyway. So, yep, resilience.
Don't feel bad. You still have more than me.
Alright, so, you somehow, this wave, you see, more crew members get washed, overboard, and you somehow hang on to this flagpole or the cannon. You can kind of feel the cannon or the flagpole kind of loosening out of its place. and all of you guys kind of see Heartwind, like, somehow, just, like, I guess, how would you describe yourself?
Probably, like, losing my footing at first, but then just, like, fucking grabbing onto the cannon and just, like, eating most of what the wave is trying to wash me off. And then just stand back up on the front of the ship again. Just kind of keep staring the storm down as I keep taking the brunt of what the rest of the crew is going to hit.
Okay.
Here we go, boys.
So more waves start to kind of splash into the onto the ship and like kind of soaking the two down here. And the winds are getting extremely, you know, hostile up in the crow's nest. You can kind of hear creaks and turns from the wood, base of the wood. Harrier is doing his best to kind of balance the ship out as you ride the waves, and two more seamen come out to assist with the ship from below deck. So that's two men gone. One of the steamer will come out and look at Frederick and be like, "What are you doing?"
Staying strapped down.
This one will look back at him. "Oh, he's no help. He scattered the water. Ah, useless." And then they'll like run around and like, you know, pulling all the fucking, I don't know, fucking ropes and whatever the fuck they do.
Embrace the rigging.
Yeah, so now if you look off to the left and you see yet another wave consume another ship, and it actually hits it with such brute force that it like splits it in half.
Whoa, shit.
Adriel, protect me, please. Lady,
and now like now there's like lightning, freaking like lightning strikes hitting throughout the storm as well. One striking a smaller ship, about probably a little bigger than your ship, and then like basically just imploding it, I guess.
Damn. Oh, this is hell.
Yeah, the lightning strikes definitely don't seem natural. Like, the storm is definitely not a,
Do I see anything on the Winds of Magic?
No, you don't.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, fuck. Oh, the gods just pissed. Oh, fuck me.
I don't think they paid enough silver.
Please, Holy Lord, I gave you all I could.
That's three ships, so now there's only 12 left.
This expedition is gonna fucking capsize at this level.
Don't worry, we got this, boys.
So as you guys are,
oh my
like,
god, my dad.
You guys are, yeah, he's below deck. you guys, he's safe with Monty and Dietrich.
Okay.
And you actually see, like, sailors, like, carrying buckets of water, out from the hold and throwing it overboard as well. Because some have
well,
gotten.
We sprung a leak.
As you guys are riding down this, this giant wave, you hear this, the petty officer on this side. He says, "Watch out! The cannon's getting loose!"
Oh no.
And you see, like, how it was, like, bolted down. It comes unhinged and strikes the base, with a tremendous force, cracking it. in half, and it slowly starts to tip.
Oh god, Nylophy!
Oh god, I cut the rope!
Nylophy, get down from there! And I'll turn around to try and fucking get control of the cannon, like, ram my shield under the fucking wheel.
I'm definitely gonna cut the rope, but I'm gonna be getting into a space and just shouting up, jump to me, to where I am.
Let's let me like describe the whole scene, and then we'll get the rules.
Yeah.
So as it like starts to crap, you get crack.
crap. And
you
crack.
You guys cut the rope off, and you see it kind of slowly like falling. But as it's falling, and Nylophy's getting ready to do whatever she's gonna do. A wave brushes up onto the ship.
Fuck.
Everyone roll, roll an athletics check. And then, Nylophy, what are you doing as it's, like, falling down?
So which way is the mast falling out of curiosity? Like, that way? Or that way?
This way.
I'm a fortune.
Argus, it'd be falling like this way.
Glad I've ghosted my ship.
There we go.
So that's going that way. Trying to think how to fucking phrase this shit. Because it'd be like half climbing, half basically scrambling down the mast as it's falling to land somewhere around here on deck.
Slide.
Let's see.
Sliding. Falling softly.
I'd probably just be athletics. That's just a catch all.
Yeah, because there's no acrobatics. There's athletics. It's basically it.
Yeah, I'd roll like a minus 10 athletics.
All right.
Good luck.
Gonna fortune Uh-oh. That, obviously. Come on. Damn it.
Nope. Uh-oh. Was that the only guy that passed?
No.
Kyle Hartwin did. He did 40-40. 40 for 40.
40 out of 40, baby.
You know, I'll fucking take a corruption, right? Wait, what's it tied to? Willpower, right? That's your limit?
Your limits... I gotta find it.
Willpower
your...
and toughness.
Willpower and toughness.
Yeah.
I mean, fuck it. I'll take a corruption point. Absolutely.
Okay.
God fucking damn it.
Well, I guess guys don't like you today.
Yeah,
oh,
right.
I already fixed it.
I don't think I have any other options aside from just taking the resilience. Which I'd prefer not to do.
Resilience is your only option, or you could just let it play out and see what happens.
That's the thing, right?
So you're only two options right now.
Also, where do I put corruption points?
All the way down the bottom near your inventory.
Why there? Out of curiosity. Oh, there it is.
Because nobody wants to see them.
It's the deepest dark.
Fair enough. Okay. Ah! God damn it!
It is you who God has damned today.
I want to avoid spending resilience, but I gotta spend the resilience at this point.
Damn, Danny, how does it feel to die to water twice?
It's gonna be pretty great. I'm gonna make a character who can actually fucking swim next time.
Oh, you're gonna go for the boatman this time?
Yeah. Boatman, dump all of my fucking skills and swim. Gonna be goddamn fantasy Michael Phelps.
Jesus,
your resilience for finishing a campaign, basically, right?
It's like...
You have to do something major towards your character.
Yeah.
Like your goals.
Alright, either way, I'm gonna have to spend that resilience, I think, just to pass.
Okay.
On the bright side, it's a spectacular pass.
So,
yeah. So you, how do you navigate your,
Right, as the mast is starting to fall, dagger out, cut rope, hop over the bucket wall thingy, and start half running / stumbling down the mast, jump off, roll on the fall to land on deck as it like collapses or some shit.
Okay.
God damn, this is looking like shit for everyone involved.
Yeah, the like it breaks, like it hits like the remaining of the
land around there.
Of the like thing hits the side of the ship, breaks off into pieces and falls into the sea. You see Harrier's face of just pure rage, and says, "Gods, why do you forsake us?" And you'll like grab his money pouch and like throw it into the sea. and then Hartwin, you roll me a, I guess.
Wait. Hang on, how tall was the mast?
Massive.
Yeah.
Pretty fucking tall, dude.
Okay. Carry on.
Roll a strength check if you're trying to like ensure that a cannon doesn't go over.
14.
I don't think you should do that. No, it worked up.
Let's just come over, like I said, just jam my shield against the wheel and like pin it up against something.
Okay. Yeah, so as you do that, you see the sailors come down and quickly tie it back down and kind of like do a makeshift bolt down job. And they'll like tend to their, like, running around and trying to, like, save the ship type deal.
So we refasten ourselves down the three knots.
So you guys don't hear, or you guys don't see anything, but you hear this off in the distance.
Hear what? Oh, nah!
Oh, Lord.
The fleet's in danger!
Nigga, why? Everything!
And you see here, cannon shots! From where?
Find the flashes!
Yeah. Malathy, where?
Perception time?
Yep.
God damn.
You're the only person that can see right now.
I'm just gonna fucking restart roll 20 right quick. Yeah, I can't change that, so I want to take a corruption, which I don't want to do. Well, fuck. How badly do we need to fucking see, guys?
I want you to remember how you got on Monty.
Well, here's the thing, right? If
I know this is all for our lives and shit, Monty lives for a personal gain.
And it's tied to fucking willpower plus toughness, right?
Mm-hmm.
I could take 8 corruption points before mutation, then or mental mutation, being an elf. So I can afford another point. Just fucking go. I quit. This is a bad night for all of us, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
I don't know, I'm feeling pretty sexy.
I rolled the exact same thing. I rolled the literal exact same thing. What is happening?
You already spent your fortune for the session.
Yeah, that's another corruption point. Alright, I'm fucking done.
Oh. Could the regular humans roll?
No.
Yeah, what's the
size? Shit. Like, roll me at a minus 20.
Roll anyway, might as well get the 1, right?
I mean.
Hey! Oh, fuck!
If I
minus
do
20,
actually,
minus
I am
20
going
perception.
To. I am going to.
There we go!
Oh, no, Mark, you got it! So, critical success. So, that's actually plus 7.
Alright, so, Rika, you see, like, I don't know, like, you're not really sure how you're able to see this through, like, this shit show, but, basically what you see is you see a warship, kind of, like, at the bottom of a, oh, that just totally...
It's Christ.
Sorry.
Only one nat one.
At the bottom of this giant wave, and there's like a coming down on them, and it looks like they're shooting into the middle wave, And so you see that, and then you also, everyone hears this.
God, what did I do to you?
But it's like a lot louder, and it just echoes throughout this entire storm. And out of the middle wave, up the giant wave, you see a monstrous creature kind of dive out. This isn't like near you guys, but I'm just gonna...
just visual.
Oh my god.
Oh, fuck this, dude.
Oh,
this expedition
shit.
Is cursed.
The sea gods don't fuck... Whatever fucking person fucked with this island originally really pissed off the gods.
And you see these two side heads latch themselves onto the side of the ship and basically pull it underwater as this middle mouth is just like eating it like a sandwich.
Hopefully that saves them. Oh god.
Yeah, it's like a monster! That,
it's just like going down. And no one else sees this except for...
Well, we heard her yell.
So that's 11 ships left.
Fuck.
It's a monster.
And you guys are just kind of being like thrown around at this point. Everyone make a perception check.
Is it normal this time?
Yeah, normal.
Thank you. Oh shit. Oh, there's your perception. Hey!
God damn.
Nope. That's hard no.
He's not a fumbling.
You guys, whoever passed sees a dark shadow, I guess, of some sort, dark figure, pass under the boat.
Boy. God? Is that you?
Harrier says, "Man the cannons!" And you see the sailors, getting onto the cannons.
I don't know if we should fight this.
I immediately get ready and guard the fucking people manning kids.
Yeah, I'm gonna take out my blade as well and prepare my shield. I'm gonna tell Rika to get over near Nylophy.
So as you guys are kind of getting situated, you hear this from underneath the ship.
Papa, I don't want to be a cranberry.
But it's like a lot lower tone than what was heard before.
Oh boy.
Stand there with a fucking swinging a sword. What the fuck am I gonna do to that?
Hold your pussy and
the
pray to God.
Best I can.
And there's a smaller wave that is coming towards the side of the ship, and this creature emerges from it.
Oh boy!
Shit! It's Black Jaws.
The Devil Prawn.
This is what it looks like.
Oh hell no!
Oh no! That's horrifying.
It's about a little bigger than the ship itself.
Wow!
Huh?
We gonna be eating good.
I ain't eating this motherfucker. This nigga wants me.
I'm just gonna. We're gonna I'm not be gonna eating. Put it on the whole thing. It kind of like lifts. Kind of like bursts through the wave and strikes. Cause you see how it has like different like arms and stuff.
God.
It strikes down and holds on to the ship. Here, here, and here, killing this man.
Oh boy.
It just like impales him.
Just start screaming into this man here, fire into the body, and start trying to hack at this thing's leg.
Sorry, Buckaroo.
Everyone roll initiative.
Initiative is your... It has a...
In the arms of an angel.
Mine is actually 30 now. Hooray.
Heartwind is roaring!
What have I done?
Jesus. You doubted.
I didn't doubt shit.
You doubted.
Oh, boy.
No,
oh, yeah, I got it.
What? Two. Help me. Thank God. I watched this man come up with an ungodly number for this thing's initiative.
This creature's gonna fucking need it. Heartwind is not gonna fucking surrender this goddamn ship that easily. It will not be eaten by the waves today.
And I'm gonna put the Harrier and the other guys on the same
initiative. So 12. Yeah. I'll take it. Well, you got a cannon primed and propped at its face, so fire, bitch.
This is why I was screaming in his ear to shoot. I swear to God, if this isn't fucking enough to make up for the shit that Heartwind fucked up on.
Alright, so a Heartwind, one of its, giant, arms, kind of like a spear just strikes through the ship. What do you do? Like, right next to you.
I'm literally gonna start trying to hack into it while screaming for this man to fire.
Okay. Yeah, roll me a test. At this point, it's all minus 10.
Oh, minus 10.
On a test due to, like, you know, the conditions and stuff.
Shit.
Sorry, you're messed.
All fortunate. Fuck it. We're dumping all of them early. Fumble.
Oh, my God.
I throw the sword. Probably.
Well,
are you going to keep that?
Corruption?
That would be would it be resilience or resolve at that point? Is it gaining corruption?
What?
It would be resilience, right?
For what?
A corruption. What?
No, you just get a corruption point. That's it.
Yeah, you just get a corruption point for choosing to re-roll again.
I guess I'll do that because.
Yeah, you don't want to lose your sword right now.
Yeah.
That's a bad thing.
I mean, I would definitely go man mode with a dagger, but, you know. That's life!
There you go.
Three corruption.
We're just good. Took the price of your soul.
I still have it. That's nonetheless better than the other people in the situation.
That's fair.
Nine damage.
Okay. Yeah, you strike its into its arm, getting past a little bit of its natural armor, but it seems to be not very effective.
God damn it! I knew I needed Slayer.
The hide's tough. Swing as hard as you can. Fire! Fire!
The sailor will fire his his shot. And it's a hit.
Hey.
And it strikes it right in a dead center in the like kind of like the chest area, I guess. And it kind of goes off, and it kind of just tilts its head back and kind of just roars and clenches down even more. Harrier is just controlling the ship, and this guy will run over to the petty officer, run over to his cannon, and start to reload it.
Alright.
Frederick.
He's gonna shout over to Nalithi and Enrique to figure out how that cannon works and make it shoot. And I am still in an app position so I can charge this thing. Whatever works. So that just negates the negative 10 I would have to try to hit. Great roll. Oh fuck. Damn it! I didn't do it on a weapon again.
Oh, so that hits.
So you flip that, that'd be, well, it's only one place to hit it. So, well, it's the same damage as he did, so 9.
Oh, yeah, so you strike it in. Hear a little crunch, but it doesn't loosen his grip at all.
Help.
Oh, fuck.
Alright,
help me.
So this creature is going to basically lift this arm up, and he is going to try to spear Hartwin in. If you try to parry, it's a minus 2 from its size. If you try to dodge, it's just a minus 10.
We are going to try and parry. Because we at least have a shield to cancel out his 2.
You still also have advantage, remember?
That's right.
It's only 1. Shields don't do.
So wait, his is only 1?
Well, you had 2 success levels.
So shields don't give you the rating in parrying. It's just 1.
Alright.
But you have advantage as well.
Alrighty. Cool. So.
Actually, technically, that would still be a success.
How?
Because you have plus 1 success level when you're doing defensive. So that would be a straight 0.
That is. That is true.
That's true. You added that in, I
didn't add in the plus 10.
Mm-hmm.
I have.
Oh, yeah.
Did you add in the minus 20?
The minus 20 I did not, so that is a failure.
Oh, okay. Wait, so.
Okay.
Plus 10, minus 20, so. So 48, yeah. It wouldn't work out.
Thanks, that'd still be a 10, so it's still failure.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so he's going to hit you in the left leg.
Fuck.
Yeah, you got good armor. You'll be fine.
Yeah, I don't have chainmail on my legs yet.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, we have leather on the legs.
I was saving
that for him. Well, hopefully his obituary is too hard. Lord Jesus above.
This is gonna hurt.
Actually, do you have any fortune left, Josh?
Unfortunately not.
Okay, I would have said you could do the plus 1 success level.
He is going to do 15 damage.
15 minus 6.
That's the healthy chunk.
That does 9 to me. Hartwin's still.
You're almost down, dude.
Alright, yeah, so he comes down and takes a good chunk of your, of your leg, sending you in you know, a good amount of pain, and then he'll readjust his grip back onto the ship, and now he will attack with this leg, Frederick.
Well, why?
Because you taste. You do cranberries, you know.
This is unnecessary. I am puzzled. So it's the same as what happened to Hartwin, so negative 10.
Yeah, so it's negative 20 if you try to parry, and a negative 10 if you want to dodge. But he also has advantage from hitting Hartwin.
Oh, you lose your advantage, Josh. You
didn't
do that already.
And then he...
Wait, but does that advantage count towards me?
Yeah. He does hit. He hits you in the body.
I'm gonna try and parry. So that'll be a negative 10. So let's try. A. Is that good enough for you?
Plus 4. Yes.
Alright.
Alright, so. As he strikes your shield, he does 1 damage to your shield.
Ooh. Oh, fuck. That's not good. Alright, so that's telling me I need to start rolling out of the way, because my shield can only take another hit.
Alright, so he will now strike Nylafi with this leg.
Fuck.
Or attempt to, anyways.
And lose his advantage for failing.
Yes, he misses. He strikes right behind you, right over your head.
God damn.
Well, he lost his advantage, I'll take it.
Nylafi.
Levis knows how to use a cannon, right?
Do you have black powder weapon?
No.
Then no. You have no idea.
All right.
Fuck. Okay, so mechanically speaking, right, I just want to clarify this. Hitting you with a sling, same as hitting with a sword, more or less, in terms of damage. Like, there's no weird DR shit. Does that make sense?
I don't understand your question.
Damage resistance.
Yeah. I mean, you can try to make a nature beast, I guess, but
a
I mean,
war beast. You want me to do it anyway, just to, you know, figure out the fuck this thing is, hopefully? That'd be...
That would probably be very helpful.
I hate everything.
Wow. Ooh. Wow.
Yeah, I'm probably just gonna fucking... Shit. I'm just gonna back up a bit, use my swing, see how that works. That's in the main hand. Boop. And where the hell is goddamn swing on this sheet? I went up and I should have gone down. Swing, let bullet roll. And this is close range, but not point blank. So minus 10 overall. Plus 20 for short range. I think that's it. Any bonuses for the thing being a big target?
Yeah. Actually, let me see. You will get a plus... 60. So it's...
That was put me at plus 60 for the map.
Yep.
Shit. Still fucking roll a goddamn 67. Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
11 damage.
Okay. Let's see. Yeah, you strike in his body, and it kind of just, like, you know, I guess it might look like it jerked it or not. It might be the waves. but it doesn't like embed into its armor.
Okay. Gives me an idea. Yeah, that'll end my turn, I guess, because I can't do much else.
Rika.
Ah.
Do you have black powder?
Fuck no. I'm a doctor. Right. I am out of my element here.
Wait, isn't there like a penalty for not having it?
This is a negative like 20, ain't it?
I believe it's usually a negative 20 if you don't have training in it.
I mean, yeah, I can certainly try, but it's...
Nigga, please do. Constructs aren't doing shit.
I mean... Oh, fuck. Minus 20?
Minus 20.
Hang on, would you get a bonus? Because it's point blank.
Yeah, you get the... Well, it'd be enormous too, I guess. It'd be plus 60.
So, go ahead.
You got plus 60. Plus 60. Because point blank gives you plus 40. Big gives you plus 60. Minus 20.
Ah, okay.
Caps out at 60.
Okay. I got you.
Well, I'm shooting a cannon.
How'd you almost fuck that up?
Awesome. Because right, the dice fucking hate me.
You strike it into its side, and it releases another great roar, and part of its shell is exposed, or like its shell like falls off, so it's like flesh is exposed.
Excellent work.
Started going ham.
Meanwhile, there's just blood all over him.
Yep.
And as that happens, another wave strikes the ship.
Fuck.
Flex check.
Would I add advantage to that because it's kind of like part of combat?
No, because it's just environment.
Well.
And that wouldn't make sense because you struck a fucking...
Yes.
Fair enough. And that's without the advantage.
I get it would have to be a resilience, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
It
would just have to be resilience.
Take another corruption.
Let's look at the other options.
Because resolve only gets rid of conditions, I'm pretty sure.
Resilience lets you pass automatically. You're out of fortune. You can take another corruption to re-roll it.
Playing a dangerous game, I wouldn't do it.
Yeah, it's fuck yourself in the foot later or lose a permanent resource, more or less. Oh, not a permanent one, but a major resource.
Both are major resources.
Mm-hmm. Because remember, like, Josh is over there stacking them up right now. He's got, like, four?
Three.
Three, okay. This will be your fourth.
I'm not taking the crush, I'm taking the resilience loss.
Yeah, because you got pure soul, so you can take, like, one more than me, right?
Did anyone fail?
I spent a resilience.
Yep. This is for the seaman.
Danny.
You didn't roll.
Oh, sorry. Oh, Danny didn't roll. Athletics. Sorry.
This is for the seaman XC Hartwin.
Oh, shit.
This is for the petty officer.
Okay, he's good. At least he's good.
Jumps into the mouth of the giant monster.
Alright, so this guy gets splashed into this guy's like spiky arm and basically gets impaled by like his armor and dies.
Fuck.
Oh, and then Rika you wish to re-roll that.
Yeah.
I would force it, Danny.
Oh wow, thanks. One fucking...
Wow.
Danny, you can't complain the shit I've had to deal with today. Oh fuck you, I deal with this shit every day.
Danny gets fucked by the dice for
worse. This is my life.
God, I'm happy I passed the check, but I'm not happy at the same time because I know this nigga's about to go all Mongo on me and try to beat my ass.
Alright, do you wish to spend a resilience or roll for corruption?
Nah, it's fine.
No?
Uh-oh.
It's not like they'd work anyway, it's fine.
Danny, did you just see what happened to that nigga?
You can fucking use resilience, Danny. It's just automatically
resilience. Pass. Yeah, you automatically pass if you spend your resilience. How much resilience do you have?
It's fine. I have two. Danny. It's fine.
Okay, the man has spoken.
You can do it, you fucking maniac.
Alright, so the wave, you know, well, I already told you what happened to everyone else. The wave lifts up Rika and sends her to the edge of the ship. Make a athletics check to ensure you hold on to the, or to catch the edge as you're falling.
Make sure you're not dead. Goodbye.
Oh my god.
Fortuning that. My hopes
please
are lower than dirt.
There you go, awesome. See, there.
So you get hit by the wave and you're rolled onto the edge of the ship and you're now hanging for dear life at the edge of the ship. Just kind of dangling as, like, the waves are below you and this thing's arm is right next to you. So you're, like, basically dangling.
Off the ship. Help! Just so much screaming.
And, as all this happens, more creatures burst out of the sea.
Fuck those guys.
This is what they look like. Harpy-like creatures. But they're very, like, scaly. They have a bunch of, like, water... Water-like fungi, I guess, all over them.
Isn't that from Final Fantasy X?
I don't know. I just looked up Harpy. And tried to find, like, a fishy-looking Harpy.
What the fuck is going on anymore?
I don't even know, man.
Does it have a goofy smile or not? I can't tell.
No, it's like snarling and... Oh, I don't know about the picture.
That's a goofy smile.
No, I'm talking about the picture.
Oh, I don't fucking know.
Oh, that's not a goofy smile. That's a sinister smile. He sees meat.
And then I'm just gonna roll the shame initiative for these.
Oh my god, help. I did not need this.
Alright, Hartwin.
Just gotta keep striking at this boy. Gods help us.
Yes!
Let me look something up real quick.
Critical success.
Stab it in the brain. Instantly dies.
Can't get that far.
I'm just hoping to chop off a leg here.
Should be at least able to be able to chop off the part. Then again, this nigga has tough ass armor, so I don't know.
Alright, now he probably soaks a whole huge portion of that shit.
Mm-hmm. You're gonna have to just do your best and hope you roll high for the crit.
I'm gonna have to hope I roll high for the parry.
Oh yeah!
I already just got impaled through the fucking leg.
Sorry, I wrote down a trait it had, but I didn't write down, like, its description. Huh. Alright, so, yeah. So it has the impenetrable trait. So, all critical wounds caused by an odd number to hit, such as 11 or 33, are ignored.
Doubles. Fuck! I basically...
Like 22 and 44 would work.
Who's
that? That's just odd numbers that don't work.
I probably just did dick all damage to this thing, but still, at least struck true.
Yeah, was you at 6 to that?
Yeah, at 6.
No,
it's negated.
Okay. Oh.
The impenetrable trait.
Oh. Oh, well, fuck.
Why do you think I want plate mail so bad?
Whale ship.
Okay. Yeah, you strike it. What was being normally a clean and powerful strike, but it just bounces off of the armor.
Oh, jeez. 7 damage is not enough.
How far away is 10?
Is that it?
Yep. The flat 7 is not enough!
Alright, Frederick.
Yeah, I can make it. I am gonna hustle over towards Rika. Saying that apparently fucking strikes of this magnitude are not doing dick. And there's a big claw right next to her. Mm-hmm. So I'm definitely moving over to try and assist her out and like getting her back aboard.
I think that's your full move, right?
Yeah, that's my full move.
Extra movement's 4, so I think you can.
I can run up to 16. That's my full move.
Yeah, okay. Alright, sailors will come from below and will assist with reloading these weapons.
How long does it take to load them shits?
So this one.
Oh no.
We're in danger.
Yeah, this one will, it will actually, strike next to you, Hartwin.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh.
Ooh, and strikes true. Roll a dodge check or fall below deck.
I like how you rhymed.
It's a minus 10 right now?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, our dodges are shit, aren't they?
You know, they're not bad. Not great.
Alright, how you keeping it?
I mean, I don't really have an option.
Alright, so yeah, you, he strikes through, it's gonna get messy. Basically, collapsing. Like,
oh, fuck my dad.
Of the deck. And then he resets his.
Up above.
Yeah.
Fucking asshole.
Oh, so you fall down on your back. It's not a big enough fall to hurt you. You land in like a sack of potatoes or something. but you look and you see Monty, Dietrich, and the father like cowering in fear. And Dietrich's like, what the fuck is going on?
Clean the shit out of your pants, grab some buckets and help! Go to sit up and shit.
I like how unless it's like a major life-threatening event, I forget I have a father.
I mean, literally, oh, your shit. Life is on the line.
That was it. That was true. He's gonna attack the seaman.
No, it's the seaman.
The seaman. He's gonna see you later.
Now you're gonna judge. He's gonna juke the shit like a pro.
Alright, so he will, he'll miss.
Yes! The juking!
He will now, attempt to strike, Frederick with this claw.
Oh boy.
How about you don't?
How about you do?
Just leave my booty alone, sir.
The other option is reek his butt.
Alright, so he will miss with that one as well.
Ah! Thank God.
Now these harpies.
Oh no.
This one is basically going to swan. What is it? Okay.
Did you say swan? Oh, swan dive?
Yeah. Swan dive into the night of its life.
Is going to swan dive into Nylaphy.
Interesting attack pattern, but alright.
I mean, they're flyers, dude. They don't hear the mortal methods.
Like, a swan dive is majestic, you know?
Yeah, it's like,
majestically fucking your ass.
As it's coming towards you, it speaks kind of like a weird, like, it sounds like a very weird, twisted dialect of Elvish. And it screams at you, "Your soul will go to the bottom of the sea!"
Oh, fuck.
And it's, dismissed.
What the fuck is this expedition? God damn it!
This one will, fly over here. And this one will fly over here. Like this way.
Leave me alone.
This one tries to, I can't do that. This one is going to, try to grapple to boy Rika.
Oh. I'm sorry, Danny.
That's alright.
So, this is going to be a inflicting damage. This is going to be a melee brawl.
Melee brawl?
Mm-hmm.
Here, it's not a brawler. Yeah, melee brawling right beneath the base. Oh, never mind. No, yeah. Oh, holy shit.
Oh!
She lied. She is a brawler.
I mean, terror and a big lends bitch. Strength to certain attributes.
She might not be. She is naturally a brawler. She just doesn't do it.
So it tries to like claw onto your face and like grab you by the head. Be able to kind of fend it off. This one will fly over here and try to do the same thing. So you have one advantage now.
Sweet.
So yeah, roll another melee brawl with a plus 10.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay. It wins, and you are now entangled.
Angle.
Yeah, so let me pull it up for you. I'll just paste it. So, well, I'll just read out. You are wrapped in something restricting your movement, aka the harpy. It B, whatever. On your turn, you may not move, and all your actions involving movement of any kind suffer a minus 10, including grappling. For your action, you can remove an entangle condition if you win an opposed strength test against the source of the entanglement, with each SL removing an extra entangled condition.
Okay.
And Ilefi, your turn.
Can I switch hands of my sword in my dominant hands of my swing and then attack the thing?
Sure.
Alright. This is the first time I've used melee, guys. Let's do this shit. I got one advantage. He said minus 10 for everything, right?
Not for strikes.
Okay. Fucking hell, where is... There it is. Yeet.
Okay.
Okay, fuck. It will attempt to... dodge.
That was a good roll on my part. Wait, did I do damage right?
Okay, it does not dodge.
It's a hand weapon, so...
it's 4 plus strength, right?
Yeah,
then it's 7. Alright. Cool, that's 12 damage to the body.
Okay.
And I think that's my turn.
Alright, so yeah, you strike it into the body, and the strike does a significant blow. It starts to kind of bleed everywhere, and it curses at you in like a twisted, like again, elvish tongue.
Alright then.
You're now dangling off the side of a ship with a harpy that's basically has you grappled. So really the only thing you can try to do is break free your grapple.
I will attempt to do so.
Make a post strength check.
Just strength?
Yep.
It's fine.
Alright, it will pass. So you are still grappled, unless you want to try to fade it or something.
Nah. I have one last fortune point. I'll try it. Hey, right. It worked.
Okay. Yeah, you'll actually beat off its harpy little greedy hands, and so you are now free of a grapple, but you are still dangling.
Moving up the world.
Ready.
All right. So as this happens, another wave comes crashing down onto the.
Fuck.
This one is smaller wave, so it is, let's see, where that says minus 10 usually, so this one is just going to be flat.
Annoyance.
Yes.
I'm gonna grab what's my at. Fuck it, just two. Go. I'll attempt to corruption, let's go.
Okay.
Oh yeah, Heartwing, you don't have to because obviously you're below deck.
I don't think as much.
Do I have to still?
Oh yeah. Yours is actually probably gonna be a lot lower, actually, because you're hanging off the side of it. Thing. So I'm going to have to give you a minus 20.
Ooh. Ooh.
Yeah, no. What's corruption?
No.
I don't have any fortune points.
You have resilience.
You can give up corruption, man.
Resilience.
You're not a lord and savior, fucking Zeech.
Resilience.
If you want to spend a resilience, roll a corruption point.
How does the corruption points work?
You take a corruption point, you get to re-roll it. That's all it does.
Sure.
That's not all.
Cut to it does more than that. Well, getting rid of the corruption point's a whole nother thing. All right.
Oh.
Wow. Thanks, Dark Gods. I really appreciate it.
What did you do to the dice?
Nothing that I remember. I don't know. Maybe I, like, burned a bunch of fucking random die when I was a child in a strange ritual I can't remember.
Alright, do you wish to spend a resilience?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Yeah. Mark down one resilience. You are now still holding on to the side. But you don't get washed away.
Oh, shit, dude.
That's everyone's good, right? Yeah. Yeah. Well, let's see. Seaman, one.
Okay, he's good.
Broski's good.
Petty Officer.
Yes!
The
good.
Other one.
He's gone. Fuck.
This one's like, ah, and he falls into the mouth.
Huh.
Your turn.
Poor bastard. Alright, so... can I run back upstairs?
Yeah. Yeah, just, you're able to get upstairs, yeah.
Here comes the mighty midget.
Move any further, I guess you'd have to use a, like your full action.
Athletics.
Fuck it. I'm gonna just keep the leg busy.
Yep. Frederick.
Well, since she's not being bothered by that damn Hawkman anymore, I'ma try to go at it.
At this one?
Hmm?
What are you trying to do?
Actually, this one. An advantage does not apply since we haven't done combat with each other yet. where is my thing?
Well, your advantage would apply to.
Oh, okay. So actually, I have plus 20 because that thing missed me, and I've been hitting it. Yeah, here it is. 20. How?
It will attempt a dodge. A dodge, yeah.
I slick one of fortune, Matt, because that just pisses me off.
Are you going to fortune, or are you just going to keep it?
I'm not going to keep it. Unless he manages to fucking beat me somehow.
You have to decide that now, if you want fortune or not.
Yeah.
You're right. I'll fortune. What do I have left to lose?
Nothing.
Oh, nice.
Good.
Yeah, so how do you kill this creature?
basically, seeing as how they're trying to drag... I don't understand what the fuck they're saying to me. They're just trying to drag her underneath. I'm going to be spearing through its wing, and I'm going to be going all the way to the right. and then letting its now dead carcass drop back into the ocean while offering Rika a hand and trying to get her back up.
Yeah, you can try to help her back up the next turn. As that attacking basically takes your action.
Mm-hmm.
Alright,
do they have a cannon ready yet?
Yeah, they have this cannon ready.
That's what I'm thinking.
They are gonna fire.
Go for the head!
I mean, you can't take a cold shot at that head if you want. I would.
Alright, so they hit it. And it, reveals another, like, it kind of takes off the, like, the armor on its, like, tip of its face right here, I guess. And then this one will start to reload. I guess, just hold on. Let's see. It is going to release off of the boat.
This gives me no relief.
And go under the water.
Oh dear.
Is it moving away?
Or is it staying nearby? It dipped under the boat.
It's going to the other side.
That's bad.
Oh shit.
Gonna stab a bunch of holes in the bottom of the boat and wait for us to sink.
Bone check!
That is what a smart thing would do. I don't know how much intelligence this thing has.
I would imagine a crustacean like most usually don't like the aspect of flipping upside down.
So this one is going to attempt to slash, it's gonna be right here, and slash Rika in the back.
Oh no.
I'm sorry, I can't help.
Alright, it will hit. You can't parry, but you can try to dodge at a minus 10.
I'm gonna take that. Nope.
You wanna keep it?
So yeah, it does hit you in the body. Alright,
what's it do?
It will deal 9 damage to the body.
You should reduce like 3 of that, right?
Minus 4, so that's 5.
Oh, you a tough rock.
You have 40 toughness, hot damn.
I don't know.
What? No, I have 30 and then I have armor.
Oh, okay. I thought you didn't have any armor.
40 toughness. No.
Alright, this one will try to strike Nalfi. And miss.
Yeah, those guys for reference. What's the rule on pairing with a hand weapon in your main hand? What's the penalty on that?
Sorry, what was your question?
Parrying with main hand weapon. That's not defense.
I'm pretty sure it's still flat.
Does it flat roll?
Right, Matt? Does anybody look into that?
Yeah, I saw... I think it's... I don't
know. Offhand has a minus 20 on.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, so it's for your main hand, it's pretty sure it's flat. Cause I think it only a negative... modifier if it's in your offhand.
Gotcha. Just want to know for a reference down the line.
So yeah, misses. Now the feet.
Another question. If I move while in its like melee range, does that provoke opportunity or no?
You break advantage.
So to do that, you can spend to for it to not attack you, you can spend, I think, what was it? You basically, you can spend advantage to move away from it, and or you can make, I think,
a dodge, I believe.
So if you have lower or equal advantage to your opponent, or do not wish to spend your advantage, you are pinned in place. If you wish to escape, you will need to use your action to make an opposed dodge slash melee test. So that's if you have a lower or equal to advantage. But there was... We're spending your advantage.
And it's not moving to escape, just reposition.
Like where?
Like, moving, like, more in deck, like that way.
Oh, that way? No, that'd be fine.
Okay, so no problem? Just using my... Yeah. The idea is just get away from the fucking edge. Naturally. Gonna shift over and take a swing, I guess. If I can remember, there it is. 20 is too bad. Yeah!
Okay, she's gonna try to dodge.
Plus 5 SL.
Alright, so how do you kill this creature?
Oh shit. Oh, is it on the ground or is it still flying?
It's flying.
Shit, okay. Probably, like, do some sweet ass, like, while moving this way, like, kind of like a spin move, you know? To, like, get, like, momentum out to swing and just stab right into its heart.
Okay. Yeah, just, and then it will, fall down onto the, onto the floor in front of you, and then just kind of curse at you in Elvish.
God damn. See, that would have been two spaces. I was moved one more down, and that'll end my turn. Because I can't just do another attack with my offhand, right? That's like it requires two weapon fighting. That feat.
Yeah. Yeah, you can only.
Gotcha.
Rika, you're still hanging off. What do you wish to do?
Try to not be hanging on there anymore.
Okay. Yeah, make me a, I guess, strength check to pull yourself up.
You got this, Danny!
Son of a bitch. I'm gonna take corruption point. Can I do that?
Yeah.
Is that the theme of this session, guys? Corruption.
How much y'all niggas take?
I'm at 3 right now.
Don't worry about it.
This is my second one.
This is life or death situation.
I'm just still over here being a good boy. I got 0.
Nothing's been fucking with you.
Oh, that's a damn lie. I've just been avoiding it. This nigga almost cracked the hell out of my shield. I'm scared.
Okay, so yeah, you you try to lift yourself up, and you lose your, how you put it? Your grip on the ledge here, and you fall a couple, feet down. Make an athletics check to try to grab onto the, like, the open porthole. That's like been cracked.
Oh shit.
Oh.
Do you have a fate point by any chance?
Nope, no fate points.
Okay.
I have one resilience point left.
No, you should have fate, just not fortune.
Oh yeah, not or, fate, well, sorry, fortune. Yeah.
Yeah, fate I don't have any fortune points. I have 4 fate points.
Wait, what?
Yeah, so he used all of his fortune, but he has fate points.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright. Do you wish to use a resilience?
Yeah, sure. Just fucking blow my shit.
Oh yeah, so you are now holding on to the porthole.
For all I got, it's a fate points my name and that's it.
Here, let me put myself right there, because technically I'm on the outside of the goddamn ship.
And then I guess this creature's like above you, but I'm gonna put it off to like the side, but it's like sharing a space with you, I guess. Hartwin. So yeah, you guys hear like cannon fire going off like crazy all around you. And Hartwin, you look above and or ahead of you, and you see a similar creature that is attacking your ship, being blown away by a warship. Like it kind of gets like its like limbs blown off, and then its head blown off. But these ships have like 20 to like 30 cannons on each side.
Fucking hell. Seeing they still won Hierarchy 2 and the matters of our situation are pretty shit. Gotta fucking go charging across the deck to try and fuck that bitch up. Wow, fucking. That's as far as I'm getting.
You can roll a. So when you run, you have to roll a.
Athletics
check. Right. And you can add. You add or subtract your degrees of success based on your SO. So you get
plus three.
Yeah.
Three I would actually more, make it.
Three more yards, so yeah, you get there.
Alrighty. That's me.
Alright, Frederick.
Alright. Well, is he still within range?
I would imagine Harpy's like one square away from me.
Yeah, you have to get right here.
Can I charge? That's what I was asking.
Sure.
Alright. Well, even if I didn't charge, I'm at the maximum for my advantage. Because I capped out by initiative. So that would only be plus two. Apparently I really fucking hate harpies.
If it dodges. It does not dodge.
I really, really fucking hate her. I'm probably seeing that it's looking down towards Rika since she fell off, and it's probably gonna try to get her as her last thing. As it's about to fly down, I'm gonna stab my sword and pin its head to the deck.
Okay.
Why is Lord of the Rings song playing?
Because it's my epic moment, boy.
I'm pretty sure that thing's about to fucking rise up and climb onto this damn ship.
Oh no, this thing about to flip my shit over. It's about to put it on the other side, you know, where we actually have working cannons and there's no one over there.
Alright, so, let's see. Another crewman will come out and they start, you know, fucking with the cannons and shit.
I'm gonna be helping Rika back up during this time. Initiative is still going, sorry.
We ain't done yet, Travis.
I know we're not done yet. I thought we had like a little brief pause for that thing. Popped up. Oh, there he goes.
Yeah, this creature is now, it basically just throws itself, on the back. It kind of, like, dives up and then just body slams onto the ship, crushing and pinning, Heron underneath.
Put him in a coffin. Oh, fuck. Oh, there goes the guy who knows how to steer the ship.
There goes the home.
remember the mast is gone, so we can't really do much.
And he kind of like rises up, and his chest starts to kind of bubble green. And huh? Yeah, his chest starts to bubble green. And anyone within this right here,
oh fuck,
must make a minus 10 dodge check.
I'm safe.
Oh yeah.
Can I add advantage to that?
Yeah.
Oh hell yeah.
Oh, I'm actually safe. I'm right outside of that shit. Hoorah.
Guess he's taking a corruption. Hell yeah.
I guess I'll take a corruption as well. And just get fucked.
What a doubt, chaos.
Alrighty.
I'm gonna shoot some of you assholes in the
back. You have resilience left.
Yeah, we're gonna dump that resilience and succeed.
Okay. Seaman. Nope. Petty officer. Nope.
And die.
Alright, so let's see how much damage do.
All these cannons were loaded when all that shit was going down, right? Well, I mean like way back at the start.
These two would still be loaded.
Yeah. Those are only two loaded ones right now. These two have already expended their payload. They need to be refueled.
So anyone that
failed
gets covered in like this green kind of like, I don't know, I guess it would kind of look like Jell-O, and it's kind of like glowing, and within it you see little tiny creatures kind of swimming in it. And the Jell-O kind of consumes, like, kind of like warps over their body, and then you see these little creatures that are like kind of like mini versions of this burrow away from like this Jell-O-like substance into their skin, and these guys are now rolling around on the ground crying for you guys to kill them.
Oh God!
They're getting eaten from the inside out.
Also, I meant like I just jumped somewhere over there or some shit.
I just feel like your person there is not really like a so you have to jump out of.
You probably like jumped over the mast because the mast is still over there.
It's like wall kick shit, who knows. Okay, so just to confirm here, these two are screaming, kill me, kill me!
Yeah.
Ah! How's Harwin looking?
He spent a resilience to,
Oh, yeah.
To not get eaten alive.
Okay. I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
The flesh on its head's, like, open, right?
Yep.
Switch hands. I'm gonna called shot head with the swing.
Okay.
I think that should amount to a plus 60 overall, cause... Yeah, maybe. Shit. Yeah, that checks out. Has advantage cancels with cold shot penalty. It's big. Yeah.
Plus 60. Plus 7. Ooh.
Alright. Does that connect and deal damage?
So it strikes it in its weak spot and it kind of like rolls its head back and screams.
Hang on. It's pummeling.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, it has to make a endurance check.
Endurance versus my strength. It'll probably win, but I'm testing. I'm sure whoever I can.
Roll your strength.
If I could roll one right now, please. That's not a one at all.
Oh,
it is not stunned.
Yeah, it will definitely pass.
Alright, for my last trick, I'm just gonna move a bit.
Just give a little bit of a section thunder shuffle.
This is gonna fucking get behind that cannon.
Alright, Rika.
Don't make it target a damn cannon.
I'm gonna try to like climb.
I feel like this part of the song is perfect for your part.
It is. Actually.
I just hope it doesn't end tragically.
Alright.
I'm gonna try to fucking climb.
Yeah, roll me a climb check. Minus 10.
Oh, Lord. dark gods, please.
God damn it.
I have nothing left.
Jesus Christ.
This is so sad.
Nope.
Oh, no.
Alright, so you don't have any resilience?
I have 4 fate points and 2 resolve points, but that's it.
You don't have any resolve, because that's...
You don't have any resolve.
...by resilience.
Oh, well, then I don't have any resolve points.
Alright, so as you're trying to climb up, your hand keeps flipping, and you just keep trying and trying, and you just don't have either the skill or the strength to lift yourself up as the waves are crashing into you, and your right hand slips off the grip you were holding, and you're just kind of dangling there, and a wave kind of crashes into your side and takes you down into the sea.
Well, I can't help, because I can't.
That's going to be some PTSD for Friedrich.
Alright, and then, can your character swim?
Let me just check real quick.
You said you should.
You wanna know the funny thing, Danny?
Yeah.
This is exactly how my mother died. This is why I followed this shit.
Oh no!
Holy shit!
It's so perfect. I can't swim at all. I'm gonna sink like a fucking rock.
This is exactly how my mother died. God damn it!
Oh, Frederick, no! Don't worry, my next character is gonna be a therapist. It'll be fine, we'll work through this.
My next coach will be a therapist.
Damn, the crushing part is, he thought he could do it this time, because he got stronger. He was a kid when it happened.
Oh, nope. No.
History repeats itself.
You're not strong enough.
Damn, Danny, what is with you and fucking with my character when you die?
I have no idea. But I love it, it's great.
Stop making ripples in all of our lives, Danny. Fuck.
I'm sorry, I can't help but have meaningful deaths. It's apparently right, what so, I'm best at.
Yeah, you are, taken by the sea and, kind of lost. From the ship, as these waves kind of take you over, and unfortunately you can't can't swim, and these waves are waves that destroy ships. You can only imagine what they would do to poor Rika.
Mm-hmm.
Washed under.
So you are. Very much.
Forced low. Depths.
You can burn a fate point if you wish.
Get washed up on shore with us.
Mm-hmm.
Somewhere, some way, somehow, the sea god just looked at you and just. You didn't do anything to deserve this. I wanted the others. So just yeets you onto some shore.
You have 4 fate points, Danny.
I do. Sure, I'll burn a fate point.
Yep.
To somehow survive this.
Harwin.
Seeing the situation, and this thing is well embedded itself in the back of the ship, and remembering that there's a cannon tied here loose, but still angled a little.
Well, no, they positioned it back here.
Oh, fuck. Either way. Well, actually, I'm just going to cut this one loose then. And try and fucking position it to point
that one's empty.
Didn't this guy repack it?
Don't think so.
No, he ran over.
He was trying.
Alright, fuck it. We're going over here then and cutting this one loose.
Okay.
And gonna try and start repositioning it.
Yep, that will be your full turn.
Alright, that's what I do. And as I'm slowly fucking. Pushing this. Get braced! Fire it!
I really wish I had a ranged weapon right now.
You just saw Rika fall into the sea and get washed underneath, and you, after she fell in the sea, you never saw her again.
You see that portrait? My facial portrait? Yeah, that's the face he's got right now. But right now, he has to save as many other lives as he can, including his.
Don't you do like a fear thing or some shit?
Willpower?
Oh no, that'll come after the battle, because right now he's a battle maniac, and he has rage, first things first.
Oh, jeez.
So right now he's gonna come over and try to assist with you turning the thing around.
That's where you turn, so you can, you just well, depending how far you moved.
You can literally walk up and fire it.
Oh yeah, that's true. So I'm going to attempt to fire at it.
Okay. Plus 60, and then I'm pretty sure you get the just the plus 60 in general.
Ballistic skill, baby.
Yeah, plus 60 for
but
sure.
You want to do a call shot if you want to hit it in it.
I know. So yeah, it'll be plus 50. Actually,
hang on,
plus
I got 60 this.
Still because I still have advantage. It still carries over. I haven't stopped.
Hang on, try. That. How much advantage you got? 2?
I have 3.
Off the top of my head, those would apply. It's minus 20 for being unskilled, right? Or is it greater?
Mm-hmm. That was minus 20 for being unskilled.
Yeah, so you got enough leeway to keep it above 60. Those are just flat 60.
Alright. So I'm gonna do this. Is black powder, right?
Yeah.
Should I do that? You know what?
You have a fortune point?
Yeah, I'm gonna fortune it.
You could just add one success level.
That's what I was gonna do. So it'll be plus 4 success levels for doing this. And that'll be my last word.
Yeah, so you fire the cannon with the...
9-0.
Help of Heart 20, you strike it and its weak point, and it basically, its head just kind of, like, gets decapitated from its body, and it slowly...
Sinks
into the ocean.
Is Harrier still alive?
So you look down and he's not moving, and he's kind of like just laying there.
Dude, I think it's covered in that goo shit. He's fucking dead.
Yeah, I'm gonna go check on that guy, see if, well, I'm sure that home is well and fucking gone.
Oh, quick question, how are these two looking?
These guys are, like, still, like, rolling around in pain, but they're also covered in, like, the jello. A lot of the other creatures that haven't entered their body, that's kind of, like, on the out, like, still in the jello swimming around.
I would... But I think that would be very detrimental to the ship, so I probably won't.
Can I have War Beast? Again?
Sure.
While keeping a safe distance, of course.
Natural.
Alright, so after, not knowing really, what the other creature was, and then kind of looking at this, what presumably its offspring is, it's definitely not something that is natural or that is known to the known world.
Alright, I know what that means.
Get him.
That shit's chaos. Fuck that.
I very easily assume that this man is dead.
So you see him, actually, Sorry, I didn't mean to say he was lying there. He was, basically there's like a giant hole right here, and he's at the bottom of the hole.
Oh, he's at the
So, his like arm is kind of like, it's still attached to this, but they're both like below deck. And then he's like, he looks up at you and he says, I think I broke my arm.
Damn, that's it?
Stay down there. We have to trying to get a handle on the ship.
As you look around the ship, all the sailors are kind of running around and trying to, you know, figure out how to unfuck this situation. Off in the distance, you see this creature still wreaking havoc among the rest of the fleet.
Is the rudder... Oh, God. Is the rudder chain still up here, at least?
Oh, no, everything's, like, falling down.
God damn it.
So now you're just being, like, moved by the ocean itself.
Yeah, we're dead in the water.
But, as you guys are kind of, like being tossed and turned around, you notice that somehow the, warships are able to position it, themselves, where this is caught in the middle, and they just start blowing chunks of it away. And eventually, you see it, retreat into the, ocean.
Okay.
What are you guys doing at this very moment? These guys have stopped moving. And actually, probably get washed away as well.
Okay, good.
Good, good.
The goo is washed away with it.
Hopefully. Yeah.
Basically, just running around now, just stabilizing what I can and. Just praying, and then I guess trying to signal one of the other ships that we've lost all control.
Okay, yeah, they so you notice that a ship is trying to make its way towards you, but it's really difficult considering like the whole storm going on. And basically, you guys are stuck in the storm running around and trying to keep it afloat for about an hour or so, as like the waves are tossing and turning, and Frederick, you think you catch a glimpse of Rika here, like at one point, but you look again and then you don't see her. And then eventually, you guys are kind of pushed out of the major part of the storm, along with the rest of the ships, and you guys kind of look north. You see the main ship north, along with 8 other ships, which are the only ones that made it out that you can tell.
Jesus.
And, you know, you guys are still getting kind of, like, you know, gusty winds and rain, but it's nothing that's going to, like, kill you or, like, drown the ship or something. And then eventually you see Lord Stalker's ship making its way to try to attempt a rescue mission.
Perfect.
And then Lord Stalker's ship will pull aside yours, and you see him say, Hardwin, get your men aboard, quickly!
Hey, everyone, basic supplies, move!
Marathi will grab what she can and hop aboard.
I'll go down Same here. And try and grab Harrier.
You grab him, help him onto the ship. Your father goes onto the ship, Frederick, and he says, what kind of adventure did you bring me on, son?
his father just sees him like with the most dead and defeated expression he's probably seen on him in years.
He'll look at you and he'll kind of like, you know, do that like fatherly hold your like face and give you a little like taps, like kind of like, you know, slap out of it, slaps of the face.
Mm-hmm.
And then basically tell you to keep doing what you need to do, and then, you know, he's old, so he's gonna go into the ship.
So he'll grab some smokes. He'll be back in a bit.
Dietrich is, say, by God! That was spectacular!
So that's at the corpses.
Gosh, yes. Men die every day, unfortunately. Things like this are not always seen. Definitely going down in the history books. Rika, where are you? Rika, we have business to attend to.
Oh yeah, where did Rika go?
She fell over.
How long ago?
Some time ago, during the storm.
Oh.
Dietrich looks pretty sad. So much potential wasted.
She probably could have done something eventually.
I don't want to think about that right now.
Well, we all knew the risks. Not exactly sure I knew of this particular risk, but there are risks involved. He'll look at, I think Hartwin's the only one that got hurt, right?
Yeah, my leg probably looks pretty fucking savaged right now.
Hartwin, you should definitely get that leg looked at.
Yes, I wanted to make sure everyone got aboard safely.
Sokka will come up to you, says, it was a tough fight. He says, don't be so hard on your guys' self. Not many can say they tangled with such sea creatures and lived to tell the tale.
It's a shame we lost so many people, but it's definitely something that massive. It's a rather unexpected surprise.
Sacrifices for the greater good. The Empire, and they were also looking for wealth. There's never such thing as any easy money.
True.
Let's hope that ensure their deaths are not in vain. He says, not too sure where we are, or what was the point of going into that storm. And you guys kind of look around, and the sea has, like, turned, like, especially, like, really calm. And you notice that it's not really, because you guys are up in the north, so it was pretty cold, so you guys are probably, like, you know, had to wear your, like, cold weather, your gear and stuff like that. But now it's actually very hot and humid in, like, almost an instant.
It's a daytime, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's weird.
It doesn't seem like typical climb into the north.
Maybe this expedition is truly blessed.
And then you notice as you guys keep moving, that the storm isn't moving. It looks like it's staying in the same spot.
And no winds of magic, yeah?
Nope.
Okay,
that shit's even weirder.
Unless tend to the other, I'll tend to the others who have been injured and fix myself up. Gotta go try and help Harrier any which way I can.
Yeah, roll a heal check.
Considering our medic got washed overboard.
Oh, that's ironic.
Yeah, you're able to kind of, like, splinter his arm. It's definitely broken, so there's nothing you can do about that.
At least set it correctly.
Yeah.
That's a fucking... Goddamn, that's a powerful 7.
Says, thank you, Captain.
It's not much. Sadly, the few I washed overboard hopefully had quick deaths. Not all the crew was lost.
Very few left, but the biggest heartbreak is my darling is now at the bottom of the sea. Most likely. Well, as it's actually, you see it, it is sinking as you guys are like
watching it go off into the distance.
Yep.
She gave you one final bout. I guess it's a good farewell gift.
Too soon. Too soon.
Apologies, friend. With that, I'm gonna go and tend to my fucking shredded leg.
I'm gonna kind of fast forward a little bit. So who has corruption right now?
Not me.
That would be...
That's everybody but me.
Me at 3.
I got 4.
I have 2.
Okay. Well, I got something for you, Rika, too, I guess. So, Rika, you're just like... You're completely fucking unconscious, I guess. and floating through the sea. But you're having, like, it kind of feels like you're awake, and, it feels like you're kind of, like, I guess, you know, like, subconscious. You hear kind of, like, little, like, faint whispers to you. Can't really make out who it is or what it is, you know. But there's that. And then, for those that are, there are a couple days past as you guys are traveling, just throughout the day, and even when you're sleeping, you guys are also hearing, like, kind of faint whispers as well. Nothing to really make out of, but it kind of feels as if something is, like, in your presence, and then just kind of, you just hear kind of, like, a weird sound of maybe something, someone talking in the background or something, but when you look around, it's usually you're by yourself, or when you're, it's just, like, a weird dream that you have.
What stone?
The stone I found before we set sail on the Nord.
Oh yeah, yeah, one quick thing though. When we look at the... When it's nighttime...
Mm-hmm.
Are all the stars in the right place, if that makes sense? Or is it kind of like off?
No, it's definitely, definitely off.
Alright. I'll point that out at some point, but continue on as normal.
Yeah, the sailors will agree with you and say it's quite strange. Especially a lot of them have sailed in the north. Don't recognize any of these, like, called constellations or something. But yeah, a couple days pass as you guys are, you know, traveling more, and it gets kind of hotter and hotter as the days go by, and more humid. And eventually, off in the distance, Neither of you are probably in like the crow's nest again or something. But you see land.
Oh god.
Hey, I see land.
You hear that? Land! Land! Land!
Oh, thank fuck.
And then, Stalker will, come out of his room and, look. Hartwin, get everyone ready to board land. I want you in a scouting party. So you, the elf, Frederick, and a sailor to scout the beach area for the rest of us land.
Yes, sir. Go down and call up the Nalefi. Nalefi, get ready. We're going ashore first. Frederick!
Well, understood.
Defer to Harrier if he's got any strong-armed men.
Yes, let's go with, Cowbell Joe over there.
Cowbell Joe!
Joe! You're coming ashore with us. Should bring you weapon at hand. I'm not sure what we'll find there.
He'll take out the Nordland specialty of a hand axe.
Very good.
So you guys get close. They're off in the distance, and you get in kind of like a smaller boat. You know, the one. A rowboat or something.
Yeah.
And it's very humid now, even more now that you've gotten closer to the island, and it's probably about like 85 degrees, 90 degrees, somewhere along there. And it looks like it's basically two adjacent kind of like islands. One's a smaller island that's kind of off to the east a little bit, and the larger island is the one that you were sent to go towards. But it looks very like tropical, like the trees have a very tropical look to them. Basically, just looks like either kind of like a jungle past the beach as you guys are making your way towards the beach. And then, like, inland you can see, like, mountains and all that kind of jazz. As you guys are making your way towards the beach, Nylefi, you actually see some washed-up rubbish on the beach. And you see a person lying within the rubbish.
I thought there was going to be a bow there. Damn it. Hey, there's a person on the beach, by the way. Not moving. Kind of just laying there in a pile of rubbish.
Go over and check it out and see if it, some poor sod who needs to be buried or if they're even alive.
I'll just be following.
Yeah, so you guys pull up, onto the beach, and when you go onto the beach, the sand is like almost like a gold color, I guess, and it's very like soft, and it's very easy to like to walk on. And as you make your way towards this wreckage, you notice that it's a familiar individual. You notice it's Rika.
Small world.
Rika? Rika!
This nigga, he's actually taking out the Roman Frederick Caesar.
I'll follow suit and be sure to check if she's got a pulse and is even breathing.
Yeah, make me a heal check to, you know, do that whole trying to, like,
see if I'm alive.
Coughs out a lung.
Oh, shit.
Alright, well,
She's dead, Jim! She's dead! You have to let her go! Sorry.
Just push her back out to sea.
She's definitely still alive, but, you'll probably have to give me another heal check if you want to, or someone else, I guess, would have to give me another heal check to,
We can't.
She can do it for herself.
Wait, hang on.
It's an advanced skill, remember?
Alright, I'm just gonna say,
How about a joke to do it?
As you guys are, well, also, she can't get healed again, because it's, the whole one time. But, she just, as you guys are staying around her, you kind of, like, push her around. She coughs up water, and, awakens.
You actually... Holy God, is he actually alive?
I'm alive?
No, I'm this alive. Is the afterlife.
This might be very sudden for you, but Frederick is actually hugging you.
She hugs right back and just starts fucking bawling. just no words, just tears.
Is she falling ugly crying?
Oh yeah, it's awful. She's been in the sun, floating on the ocean for God knows how many days. She's sunburned and just she looks like shit, and she's ugly crying. It's terrible.
So, Hartwin, what are we scouting for again?
We still need to scout out the area, but Rika, you can wait over by the boat with Joe if you need. Unless you prefer to stay with us for now. I would imagine you probably want to get far away from the ocean.
That does sound nice. Getting away from it.
Do we want to address Frederick here, Hartwin? I'll, like, whisper.
Let the man have his happiness for now.
Right after making sure she's okay, Frederick's actually gonna go near the ocean, and he's gonna toss in like 4 silver coins. Silver.
That's beautiful. 17. God damn, this is amazing.
Well, thank you, Daddy, for seeing that fate point, because you saved my character from emotional trauma.
I was really debating.
Danny PM me thinking if he should die or not, straight up.
Oh. Because just the image was so perfect in my head. You find Rika on the beach, you run over, and she's just a bloated, horrible corpse.
Oh.
I think I see someone. Oh my god, it's Rika. Let's go, come on. Oh.
Oh.
God. I don't know how fucking horrible of a person Frederick would become after that.
Nah, but no, she wants to die another day.
It's pretty bad.
It's fucking everyone's looking to the left but me. Kind of, anyway. Or their head's tilted in that.
To the left.
We don't want to be near a lot.
Oh, fuck him. Have you seen him?
Alright, and then everyone gets 500 XP.
Oh, boy.
Holy, I had a fucking bow right now.
I mean, to be fair, that kind of does constitute that much HP. So it took, boy, that was some shit.
I say no, Matt, shit. It took us a few more days to get here, you said?
Okay. Yeah.
Right. Hey, Matt. Hey, let me just check this right quick. I'll fucking come back to you in a couple seconds.
So I'll be 515.
Oh, and then, so like as, forget to add this is in my notes. So, as you guys were like kind of like traveling here, you noticed, or you're told by Stalker Hartwin, that, you lost, like, you know, the other, one of the other scout ships, a couple of, you know, warships, and then also, two of the, like, supply ships. So most of the, like, Voyage's supplies are at the bottom of the ocean. So one of, like, the major tasks now is to
find food.
Find food, and
good spot to
basically just try to ensure no weapons or armor are lost, because there's not a lot to go around.
Hey. Oh boy.
Does Harwin tell the group this?
For sure.
Can I requisition a bow and some arrows to help with the hunting effort if we find land down the line?
Do we even have bows?
If you can find someone with a bow.
Fuck!
I mean, it's a good thing we're here first, because we can check all of the shore for dead bodies. But, I mean, that's a fucking shot in the dark.
Rika's the only one that you guys see here.
Yeah.
Like, everything else would have, like, not even left the storm.
Yeah, fuck.
I'm gonna ask if I can swap out a shield with somebody, since I'm gonna be a part of the scouting party.
I'll take your shield.
No, you don't want the shield. This shit actually took a major hit during that battle.
It's better than no shield.
Make a minus 10 charm check.
Minus 10? Like, what? What?
You're a recruit. No one owes you shit.
Get fucked.
I don't remember this in the fucking winter. You guys are starving.
Maybe if he wasn't just a recruit, he might have some more sway.
I'm charming.
You say this, but your role says otherwise.
Alright, well, that's officially where I'm ending now. don't want to deal with anything else.
So we gotta find a base camp. Good supply of food, clean water.
Yeah, Matt, would Strider Woodlands apply to jungle? Because it's trees and shit.
Sure.
Alright, that's... I'll give it to ya.
Alright. I will assume we cannot spend the experience quite yet, or can we?
You can.
Okay. Now, what counts to expending XP on advances, you go by the amount of advanced numbers you have, not your actual base number. Gotcha.
Do I have to find the table again?
No, I already have the table. Just making sure.
Oh yeah, and then, Hartwin, roll me a nether.
Definitely for the amount of damage, but... I even rolled the fucking 1d2 to see if I forgot the fucking stone.
But... Oh, no, I just meant, roll me a... Okay.
Oh, shit.
Do you wish to keep that?
Don't really have an option.
You have to take a corruption point to not keep it.
One more corruption point.
Right. You're up to 5, aren't you?
4.
Okay.
Hey, we're tied.
I'm fine, though.
This is not good. Being on a very jungle place, and you guys are going to be hearing the dark whispers of insanity. This is not okay.
Nah, it's just after returning to her roots and the fucking Apple Lauren. Good times.
Okay, so... Well, I automatically know what's getting boosted. Off the rip. So, to boost that up by 2. Actually, no, I need